Thank you very much, Dan, for this insightful lecture. Two quick announcements for the rest of the evening. We have immediately after the last speaker, whom I'll present in a minute, introduce in a minute, we will have a very light cocktail here for all of you invitees here. And the second announcement is that, you know, we've dealt with the intellectual part and the practical part, but we did not deal with the design and art part. And the exhibition is out there, so please enjoy what the students have done in Berlin and in Tel Aviv. I think that this is quite remarkable in terms of the way they've translated into a different medium the core and the essence of the agreements we've discussed. It is now time for our general manager here, Udi Dekel, who himself has been a negotiator on permanent status during the Annapolis process, to take the stand. And please, Udi, go ahead.
I know that everybody is tired, and everything already have been said. But some points in the morning I told somebody, because after the Second Lebanon War, I was the head of the Israeli delegation to the three-party negotiation after the Second Lebanon War between the Lebanese Armed Forces, UNIFIL, and IDF. And my mission was in that time to convince the LAF is Lebanese Armed Forces, to convince them to deploy in southern Lebanon, because until that time, between 2000 to 2006, all South Lebanon was under the control of Hezbollah. And we didn't want that the end state of the war will be as it was before, because Danny spoke about 1701. It's very nice resolution, but you know, there is a problem of implementation of resolutions. So there was very tough negotiation with the Lebanese side, because in the beginning they didn't want to sit with me in the same room. And it was a you know, main effort, first of all, to convince them that we can sit in the same room. And the beginning of the discussions, they didn't want to look at me. They look all the time upon the commander of the UN forces, UNIFIL force. And by him spoke with me. But in the end of the process, we have become very good friends, as usual. There is very good friends of mine here, Iba, that we keep contact for many years. And the idea was that we can establish some kind of border regime, which is still stable, even today that we have the problem with Hezbollah, with the tunnels, but we can keep the situation quiet and stable by negotiating with the other side. You know, even last week we had a meeting with the Lebanese side by the UN in order to calm down the situation and to prevent escalation and things like that. So I assume that most of the people here understand the meaning of negotiating, the meaning of discussions. It's very difficult in our environment, because in our environment, most of the people believe that the only language is the language of force and power, not language of discussing and trying to solve problems between people. And this is our one of most important, let's say, objective, to convince the people all over that maybe we can solve the problems by negotiating. Even, you know, to minimize the damage, not to achieve all the goals by negotiation. And today, I can say that there is two approaches in the Israeli side. The one approach, which leading now, because this is the approach of our government and most of the people which support the government, saying that the time is ticking in favor with us. We don't have to do anything. The situation is very good. There is no partner on the other side. You know, we have to see, first of all, what will be the outcome of the upheaval all over the Middle East before doing something. In the Palestinian side, there is no partner. We will miss Abbas, I can tell you. But there is no partner on the other side. First of all, they have to solve their own problems between Hamas and Fatah and the PA. Maybe, first of all, we have to solve the problem in the Gaza, because Gaza can be spoiler for any positive process. And why we have to do something? We have better relations with the Arab world. We don't need the Palestinian anymore as a card to go to the Arab world. So why we have to do something? It's better to manage the situation. And as you heard from, and this is the picture, that the time that somebody tried to achieve an agreement, we have found that there is no way to bridge the gaps in the core issues, so why to go to negotiation? And this is one approach. There is another approach, saying because that we have better strategic situation, as Dan said before, maybe this is the time to try to do something, because we can use our strategic advantage in order to promote maybe positive process between us and the Palestinians. That we have to try to change that reality, because this is not status quo, this is flexus quo. The meaning that we are sliding every day, you know, in incremental way to one state reality. And one state will not be Jewish or not will it be democratic state. And by doing nothing, we are supporting this process. So maybe this is the time to do something, first of all, in order to protect ourselves from ourselves. And to keep Israel, if we'd like to keep Israel as the homeland of the Jewish people, democratic, yes, secured, and moral, we have to do something and not wait. And the main challenge is to convince the people that we are able to do something. Because most of the people in Israel, I know all over the world, you look in other way, you know, things that you see from one side, you don't see from the other side. But most of the people have convinced that there is no way. So we did something in our institute, some of the people in the room know about that. We did the very long research, which we check 12 options of negotiation between us and the Palestinians, trying to change the paradigm, and check 12 other options. Yes, two states, one state with equal rights to all of its citizens, one state with no, without equal rights for all of its citizens, okay? A unilateral steps, a federation between Israel and Palestine, confederation between Israel and Palestine, confederation between Palestine and Jordan, a transitional arrangements, regional aspects, annexation. You know, this is an idea which now it's very clear that some of the parties are going to lead in our side. They start with nice word of applying the law, but now speaking directly on annexation. It's good that they are saying what they would like to achieve. As Dan said, nobody say what we would like to achieve. So we check all of those 12 options. What is the best options for Israel? And it was very difficult, you know, because there is so many indicators, how you compare between all of those options. So what we did, we build up, produce, let's say, future scenarios. I don't know what will be the future. I cannot predict the future. So I can achieve or create a lot of future scenarios. And we check between all of those 12 options, which option survive those possible future scenarios? And what was the outcome? I know that people don't like it. Two-state reality is the best for us. So what we can do today, yes, in order to shape the two-state reality, this is the big challenge. And there is the framework that we worked about it, and you can read about it in our site. And we try to, you know, we try to promote those ideas in the political echelon with the public, on the other side of the world, other side of the ocean. But The idea not to do and to wait is the worst option. And we have to initiate. We have to take our future in our hand and try to shape the better reality. And as we see and as we understand, the best way to do it is together by negotiating with the Palestinians, because there was another outcome from our research. The outcome that it's our interest that on the other side will be a function, stable, cooperate with Israel-Palestinian Authority. This is our interest. This is not their interest. Maybe it's also their interest. But first of all, it's our interest. And we have to consider it and to take it into consideration in our activity and what we are doing every day, you know, according the Palestinian arena. So I would like to thank all of those which were involved in this, I can say, lovely project. Because this is kind of lovely project, because there is very nice you know, exhibition outside. I assume that you saw some of the ideas are terrific. Thank you from Goethe Institute and Berlin University behind you, and Shenkar, that my daughter learned there, so I like Shenkar very, very much. And all the people behind in our institute, behind and inside that project. This is an idea that by that maybe we can promote other way to promote ideas of negotiation and to convince people that there is a lot of things, there is a toolbox that we can do a lot for our future, and it's better to initiate and come with ideas than to say we cannot do anything and it's better to wait and see. Thank you very much.